This video is brought to you by IXL, used by millions of students worldwide to get ahead in math, English, and more.
We can use one angle to find the measure of another. And to do this, we can use some tricks based on how the angles are arranged. Complementary, supplementary, vertical, adjacent. These arrangements can help us find the measure of angles that share a common vertex. Let's start with vertical. Vertical angles are angles formed opposite each other when two lines intersect. Here we have a pair of vertical angles. One is 41 degrees, and the other one we'll label with the variable n. What is the value of n? A useful property of vertical angles is that they are congruent, so they have the same measure. And that means n equals 41 degrees. Here, the smaller angles share a vertex and a side, but no interior points. They are called adjacent angles. The adjacent angles measure 30 degrees and 40 degrees. But what is the measure of the larger angle, which we'll label with the variable m? Now it's time for a useful property of adjacent angles. You can find m by adding the measures of the two smaller angles. So m equals 30 degrees plus 40 degrees equals 70 degrees. There are two special types of angle pairs, so we give them special names. Complementary angles have measures that add to 90 degrees, and supplementary angles have measures that add to 180 degrees. Let's take a look at complementary angles first. Since 90 degrees is a right angle, that means adjacent complementary angles always form a right angle. You can split any right angle into two adjacent angles, and they will always be complementary. This pair of adjacent angles form a right angle as shown by the square marker. One angle is 58 degrees, and the other one we'll label with the variable b. What is the measure of this angle? Well, since they are complementary, let's add the measures and set the sum equal to 90 degrees. So to find the measure of b, we can solve this variable equation. Subtract 58 degrees from each side, and we have b equals 90 degrees minus 58 degrees equals 32 degrees. So our missing angle is 32 degrees. Supplementary angles have measures that add to 180 degrees. So when a straight line is split into two adjacent angles, supplementary angles are formed. This pair of adjacent angles are supplementary because they form a straight line. One angle is 146.9 degrees, and the other we'll label with the variable g. We can find g exactly the same way we did before. Using the fact that the angles are supplementary, we can add their measures and set them equal to 180 degrees. Subtract 146.9 degrees from each side, and we get g equals 180 degrees minus 146.9 degrees equals 33.1 degrees. You can remember the difference between complementary and supplementary by their first letters. C is for corner, a 90 degree angle, and S is for straight, a 180 degree angle. Complementary is for corner, and supplementary is for straight. Let's keep going. There are a lot of angles here, but can we use what we know about vertical and adjacent angles to figure out the missing angle? It looks like some of these angles are made up by intersecting lines. That means this angle here, measuring 63.7 degrees, and this total angle here, are vertical angles. Since vertical angles are congruent, this larger angle is also 63.7 degrees. That's important to know because it means these two adjacent angles have measures that add to 63.7 degrees. 37.6 degrees plus d equals 63.7 degrees. Subtract 37.6 degrees from each side, and we have d equals 63.7 degrees minus 37.6 degrees equals 26.1 degrees. Great! The missing angle measures 26.1 degrees. The measure of an angle is 4 times the measure of its complementary angle. what is the measure of each angle? There are no diagrams this time, but we can still do this. Let's reread the problem and pull out some information. We need to find the measure of two angles, and we know that they are complementary. We also know that one angle measures 4 times the measure of the other. Let's use the variable k for the measure of the smaller angle. Then, the larger angle should have a measure 4 times that, or 4k. Since the angles are complementary, we know that they have to add to 90 degrees. So let's make a variable equation that adds the angles. K plus 4k equals 90 degrees. Now we can solve for k. K plus 4k is 5k. Divide each side by 5, and we have k equals 90 degrees divided by 5 equals 18 degrees. That means the smaller angle has a measure of 18 degrees. The larger angle measures 4 times larger, and 4 times 18 degrees is 72 degrees. So our two angles measure 18 degrees and 72 degrees. So remember, vertical angles are congruent, adjacent angles can be added together, complementary angles add to 90 degrees, and supplementary angles add to 180 degrees.
Head over to iXL.com to check out this video and thousands more in math and language arts.